Hello students, a very good morning to all of you. Today in this video, we are going to learn another poem, that is poem 6, The Wonderful Words by Mary O'Neill from your Honeysuckle textbook in English. Okay, so the name of the poem is The Wonderful Words, written by the poet Mary O'Neill. You will find the poem in page number 82. In your textbook, Honeysuckle textbook. Okay, so in this video, I'll give you a short explanation about this poem, and in the next video, I'll do the explanation line wise, and also I'll give out the word meanings. Okay, so now let us see this poem, but before I do the explanation in short, let me read out the poem for all of you. Okay. Imagine a world without language. All humans speak at least one language. The words we speak bring out our thoughts. Read the following poem on words. So this is about words. Okay? When we speak, we use words. And when we have thoughts in our mind, we express it through words. Okay? So this is about language. Now let me read the poem. Never let a thought shrivel and die for want of a way to say it, for English is a wonderful game and all of you can play it. All that you do is match the words to the brightest thoughts in your head so that they come out clear and true and handsomely groomed and fit, for many of the loveliest things have never yet been said. Words are the food and trace of thought. They give it its body and swing, and everyone's longing today to hear some fresh and beautiful thing. But only words can free a thought from its prison behind your eyes. Maybe your mind is holding now a marvelous new surprise, written by the poet Mary O'Neill. So, I'll do the explanation in short, but as I have told you, in the next video, I'll explain the poem line-wise. Okay, so without language and appropriate use of words, it is almost impossible to imagine the beautiful world. How can a world be beautiful when you can't express yourself or when you can't use appropriate words? Or if we don't have language, if we can't express ourselves, then how can the world be a beautiful world? Words and the art of expression help to express our thoughts. Whatever we have, okay, we have in our mind, how do we express? We express through words only, okay, through the language. Okay, now in this poem, The Wonderful Words, the poet says that words are the vehicles of thoughts. So whatever we have, the thoughts, we express it through the words. Okay, so words are the vehicles of thoughts. Thoughts die if one does not know how to say it mannerly. So one should learn and stock words. One should learn how to stock the words. Okay, how to express it. Express it mannerly. To learn the style of expression is also compulsory. The poet says that English is an interesting language, so everybody should read or learn it. Appropriate words are required to express thoughts, but words must match. It will help you to express ideas clearly, beautifully, and effectively. So in lack of appropriate words, many ideas are not expressed. If you are lacking, okay, of appropriate words, then many ideas are not expressed. You may have lots of ideas. Suppose you are in the classroom and you don't know English. You can't express English. So the teacher has asked you something. You know about it. You have many things in your mind, but you don't have the words to express it. Then what happened? Now, the things that or the ideas that you have in your mind remain unexpressed. Okay, so thoughts are expressed through words or through language. So this is what the Boyd says. According to the Boyd, words act as food and trace of thought. So words is like a food and trace for thought. They give wings. Everybody around the globe means around the world, wishes to hear fresh and lovely ideas. Otherwise, they are imprisoned in the mind. Only words have power to set the thoughts free. So you have so many thoughts, you have many things in your mind, but if it is not expressed, it is like imprisoned. Imprisoned means putting someone or inside a cage where there is no freedom. So you may have many ideas, but if you cannot express it, if you don't have any words, then those ideas are imprisoned in your mind only because it is not expressed. Okay, so they are imprisoned in the mind. And now who has the power to set free those thoughts? Only words. Okay, words have the power to set the thoughts free. You might find it a little difficult, but once I do the explanation line-wise, you will be able to understand. Okay, so this is a short explanation of this poem, that is The Wonderful Words, written by Mary O'Neill. So you please watch and listen to this short explanation. And later on, you try to listen to the second video, the explanation of each line of this poem and also the word meanings. Okay. Thank you, students.